What's up, guys? New episode of Poker Life. This time it will be a little bit different. I just want to talk a little bit about things. I had a couple friends over yesterday and just cleaned up. It's like 12 a.m. now. Yeah. So a couple of changes will become. I mean, you notice I'm gone. I took some days off streaming now for the first time after 8 months. Just needed that a little bit. I plan to edit something. Actually, quite a funny story, okay? So the original Poker Life episode should have been live like 3 days ago. You know, I took some shots from the festival and everything looked really nice, super neat. And then I was like, okay, I will put on something from Tuesday in there as well. But, so yeah, so I saved everything and deleted the videos. But apparently when you delete them, before you like render the video, I'm not quite sure if that's the proper English word. Yep, it's gone. So basically, we lost everything I cut there. It was like a couple of hours of work. So that's kind of sad. But it's alright, you know, Poker Life will change anyhow. I'm not quite sure if I will continue the series. If I continue, it will be more like this. Speaking to you about things that I think about. And not like taking too many real life shots. Because I just noticed, you know, when I'm not streaming, I want to relax. And when I'm like having the camera with me, I was like, oh, that could be a good shot. Oh man, let's film that. Wait a second for me, guys. I'll put that in. And that's just not a good way to do it. Because you're never really relaxed, you know. You always have to think, yeah, what you could do, what you can take in the shot. So yeah, I think I will stop that. I mean, I will continue talking about things and all that stuff, but like, yeah, that's not even sure. Like for now, I'm just relaxing. Yeah, those 8 months were pretty insane, not gonna lie. You know, $700, and now I have like a decent amount of cash. And yeah, also streaming was pretty great. Over the last couple of weeks, you know, after our big wins, went a little bit like down, you know, I didn't play my A game anymore, so it was just like time to take a break and refocus. So yeah, I think that's pretty good that we do that and come back stronger. Right now I'm studying a bunch actually. Like my plan is to go through a lot of training videos today. I plan to like watch like 5 hours or something, also go over hands. My coach is back from the international, so he's ready to like go over some hands. I also contacted some friends of mine to talk about hands. You know, I just want to like improve. I want to be good at poker, you know. For me, it's not important. Like, obviously, you know, the problem with poker is there's not like a trophy or something like that if you're like in normal tournaments, right? So money equals results. You know, if I would win a trophy, I could say, hey, I'm on the soccer tournament, I got that trophy. Okay, I say football before people go crazy about it. And yeah, with poker, it's a little bit different, you know, like, the results are in money, you know. If you say, wow, I banked a $22 tournament for $3,200, people are like, wow, that's sick. But actually, I don't want to brag with money. For me, it's just like a big trophy because I'm pretty proud of that. So, I'm not quite sure where I was going with this. Let me think about it. So, results are not the thing that is like most important to me right now. For me, I just want to be a really good poker player. I just want to be a sicko. I want to crush people. I want to 4-bet them light. Like all these spots, man, you know, every time there's a spot where I like put out a 4-bet versus a regular, I'm like, hell yeah, fuck you, bitch. You know, it's just like, it's just a good feeling because you think like, I'm a little bit smart in that spot. Maybe it's just like a little bit lucky in that spot, you know, but just like putting in a cold 4-bet, man, it feels so sick, man. These are the moments where I love poker, you know. Obviously winning something is like insane and you're super happy about it. But every time I make like a 4-bet bluff or something like that, it's just like, it's such an amazing feeling because, you know, you always like think about tactical aspects and you always try to beat them. And I really love that about the game. So, you know, right now I'm just studying a bunch. And yeah, that will be the same in the future. Regarding the streaming, I think I will be back like pretty soon. You know, I feel pretty good already. Going for a hike tomorrow. Yeah, so that is a plan as well. Just, you know, just relaxing. It's just, you know, get the head free, but also improve a lot on the poker streets. And regarding streaming, I think what I will change for sure is like my approach to streaming. You know, I'm a poker player at first and then I'm a streamer, you know, and I really love streaming, man. We have a good community, like there's people in there, man, who are good friends now, and I will definitely continue streaming, you know, that's planned for the next couple of years for sure. But what I will change is my approach, you know, and that I'm like, every time I stream less than 8 hours, for example, I feel like that I owe you guys something, that I didn't put my time in, or every time I wasn't like super happy on that day, I felt really bad afterwards, guys, because I feel like people are subbing, people are watching, and you know, I want to give something back, but I think it's more important that I focus a little bit on me regarding that and just say, you know, don't feel good today, guys, and we'll just not stream. finish, end of story, you know? And I think that's definitely a thing I gotta change, which makes the stream better as well, you know? The last couple of weeks weren't like super entertaining as well, you know? I was just sitting there and I really didn't enjoy it. So we will change that, guys, and I think that's good to have like a different approach. Besides that, on YouTube, as said, Poker Life will change. I will continue doing stream highlights, like the last highlight, you guys absolutely loved it. And I really enjoy it, you know, right now, like, cutting isn't a problem at all. I have actually quite a bit of fun doing those thumbnails, you know, me with Fighting West France. I thought that was a good one. And, you know, just thinking about these little things, I do enjoy that. But it doesn't, like, take that much time to do that, you know. It will take, like, it's just an hour, and in that hour I can cut, and then while I upload, I watch a training video or something like that. But yeah, mainly my goals right now are just to improve as a player, as I said. And that's definitely something I want to achieve. When I decided to take some time off, I also had a chat with Doug Polk and Chicago Joey. Chicago Joey! Yeah, Joey Ingram, you know, with the podcast. Sick dude, actually. We talked for like 30 minutes or so, and it really helped me a lot, man. That guy is amazing, guys. Definitely check him out on YouTube, also a member of Team Grind Nation. I think Joey Ingram won over there. Just check out his podcast, like... He just uploaded one with Phil Galfond. I watched the entire 3 hours. It's just great, great content, you know? Like, it helps you so much watching that, and it's also super entertaining and interesting, you know, to get to know these top-tier guys, like Phil Galfond, obviously, legend. And, yeah, I really enjoy that. And, yeah, so we had a chat about things, about, you know, life, about, like, about everything, man. He's, like, pretty good. I should hire him as a mentor coach, if that's possible. But yeah, it really helped me a lot, you know. I'm super I'm really motivated still, and I want to like be really good at poker. But I, you know, in streaming, like, takes a lot of EV away. Obviously, you know, you give your plays away, you're also not super focused. But I think there's just like a couple of things that I can do, you know. If I can't read every message in the chat, then I won't. And rather focus on like something else, you know. What I also thought about a lot lately is like that I put in like a German stream every now and then, you know, like talking English for those. Like for 8 hours a day is like super exhausting and pretty much fucks your brain. And I feel like I'm a pretty funny person, but also like pretty retarded and a stupid idiot. When it comes to my humor, you know, I'm always like making jokes and like talking weird voices and shit. I'm not sure why I do that, but that's just me. And like in English, I can't really do that, you know. I don't know the insiders. You don't know like, oh, that's the dialect they speak over there, and that's really funny. So it's just tough for me to pull that off. But I feel like in German, man, I could like. I could shit talk so much and like just talk so much bullshit and have fun, you know. So yeah, I think I will put in like a German stream like once a month or something like that. And like I just want to give it a shot, you know, one time, and then we'll see how you guys like it. Once again, that's like a thing I never want to do because a lot of the subs are like from the Netherlands or something like that. And I felt like kind of bad for it, but I think I just like will do things like that as well. I mean, my main base of viewers still comes from Germany, so we'll do that. And besides that, you know, not too much banned, as I said. I'm watching a ton of the Olympics right now. Just pretty entertaining stuff. I mean, those are top tier sport guys, and it's, you know, it's pretty fascinating as well, and also really interesting. I love, you know, I love every sport pretty much. Watch a bunch of esports, but I'll just enjoy like every single sport that's out there besides something with horses. I think that is bullshit. yeah, besides that, cool stuff. And yeah, that's pretty much what I have planned. You know, today is Thursday. I'm not quite sure when I come back, as I said. Like Saturday stream or Sunday stream is in my mind, but I'm not sure if we will do that. Maybe I will just play a session on Saturday and see how I feel, you know. I will go hiking tomorrow Friday, and then I will see. My brother is leaving tomorrow as well, so, you know, we'll spend a good family day. And yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. I hope you like enjoy this. It's not like a new format, like it's still Poker Life, you know, but I just want to change it, you know, talk a little bit more, as I said, and I think that's a good approach as well. As I said, guys, if you have any feedback about things, if you have any ideas, always like feel free to contact me, guys. I'd love to read it. And I usually respond to everything. And yeah. Thank you guys for watching. And I see you soon on the tables. Maybe a little bit later. I'm not quite sure, as I said. But still, I appreciate all the kind words on the different platforms. And just all the support. It's like, honestly, it's good. It's really good. It's great. I'm so glad to hear that, you know. Even on like the Discord, where people just said, yeah, okay, Henry, man, I just subbed yesterday. But take your time off, man. That's important. And, you know, I really appreciate stuff like that. So hopefully we see. How do you say that? Hopefully we see us soon with a lot of fortune and better place as well. Thank you guys for hanging out. Thank you guys for watching. And good luck at the tables. Cheers.